Students, today we are going to do lab 0 for ROBO 234. This is an exercise where you will be learning to set the decade resistance box to different values, measure the values with the DMM and calculate the error. We are also going to connect the transformer to the digital multimeter, see the RMS voltage. We are going to connect the transformer to the oscilloscope and see the waveforms. We are going to use the function generator, set different wave shapes and see them on the oscilloscope and do measurements. We have two kinds of decade box. One is this, where you have all the resistances that could be connected in series and you can measure the resistances between these terminals. If I have to set 1 ohms, I put the switch up and measure the resistance. If I have to set 47 ohms, 40, 4 and 3, 47 ohms. If I have to set 1 kilo ohms, put them down, see here 1 kilo ohms. And this is another kind of decade box. You have the dials. If I want to set 1 ohms, this is units place, 1 ohms I set by taking the dial to this position. Next, if I have to set 47 ohms, 4 on this and 7 on this, the last two dials. If I have to set 147 ohms, 1 on this, 4 on this, 7 on this. If I have to set 1 kilo ohms, 1, 0, 0, 0. Now we are going to the result sheet. I have to first take the zero error of the DMM. I have to connect the positive and negative terminals of the DMM at the digital multimeter and check how much is the resistance shown. Now I switched on the DMM and I have to set it in ohms mode. I have to connect the positive and negative terminals together. And read the meter, it shows 0.22. I have noted the zero error here, 0.22 ohms. Now I'm going to set the decade box to these values and see how much the DMM shows for each of the settings. I've connected the positive of the DMM to one end of the decade box and the other end of the decade box goes to the negative of the DMM. Now I'm going to set 1 ohms, 1 ohms. It shows 1.43 ohms, I'm going to note in the table. Now I'm going to set 47 ohms, 4 here, 7. It shows me 46.99, I'm going to note this also in my table. We are going to do the calculation for error and error percentage. The first step you need to do is, this is the measured value that you see on the DMM. You also have a value from the zero error measurement. So in this case, for the first row, 1.43 minus 0.22 I have to do, and I have to consider that as the measured value. So measured value is whatever I see on the DMM minus the zero error. Step 2 is to calculate the error. We have to get the mod of actual value minus the measured value. Actual value is in the first column. Actual value is 1 minus the measured value is 1.43 minus 0.22. When you take the absolute, you are going to take away the sign, the negative sign. So I have got 0.21 for error. Now the percentage error or the error percentage is actual value, that is column 1 value, minus the measured value, which is measured value minus zero error, over the actual value times 100. Again, I don't consider the negative sign, I consider the absolute value. For this table, I have to connect the transformer secondary to the DMM and I have to measure the RMS voltage. Whatever value the DMM shows is RMS and I'm going to put it here. I'm going to set the DMM in AC voltage mode and I'm going to note the value here. Next is measured DC voltage. I just changed the DMM to DC voltage measurement and see whatever the value I get here. This is the transformer secondary. Primary of the transformer is here. It has to be plugged into the socket, and I have the two ends and the center tap end of the transformer. I am taking from this end and this end. I am connecting this to DMM's negative terminal and this to DMM's positive terminal. I am going to change this to DC voltage measurement. DC voltage is actually 0 volts from the transformer. There is no DC voltage from a transformer, right? So it shows in millivolts. So I'm going to write whatever value I see first. I see 2 point something, so 2.0 millivolts I shall say. I have to calculate the peak value for this column. Peak value is 1.414 times VRMS. So it is giving me 41.90 volts. Next is to connect the transformer secondary to the oscilloscope, and we are going to get peak to peak from that. V peak to peak is 2 times V peak. So 2 times 41.90, I can expect 83.8 volts as peak to peak on my oscilloscope. Switch for the oscilloscope is here, the power switch. I am clicking it on and wait for the trace to settle down. I connected the oscilloscope probe to channel 1. The oscilloscope probe should end up in this kind of terminal. Since the expected voltage is so high, 81 point something, 83 volts up to 83 volts, I have to keep this in 10 times position or 10x position. So I move the switch from 1x to 10x, and I'm going to connect it to the transformer. The tip of the probe is positive and this end is negative. I connected one end of the transformer here to the positive of the oscilloscope, and the negative of the oscilloscope is connected to another end of the transformer. You see the waveform on the oscilloscope. If you don't see this waveform, what you need to do is you have to click the auto set button. Auto set. If you click on that auto set, you're going to see the waveform on the oscilloscope. The vertical scale is here. Channel 1 vertical scale is 20 volts per division. Horizontal scale is here, 10.0 milliseconds. And you read all the required parameters here. Peak to peak voltage is 82.4. Period is 16.68 milliseconds. Frequency is 59.95 hertz. So all of these we are going to note in the table. Vertical scale 20 volts per division. Horizontal scale 10 milliseconds. Per division, peak to peak voltage it was showing 81.6, I have noted it, and peak voltage is V peak to peak over 2, so 40.8 volts. Period I saw from the oscilloscope 16.68 milliseconds. Frequency, I can read it from the measurements shown on the oscilloscope, but I can also calculate it with this formula 1 over T. So 1 over 16.68 milliseconds, it's going to give me 59.95 hertz. I have noted it here. Next part is to connect the function generator with the oscilloscope and do the wave measurements. I'm going to show you. For this part, we have to set the sine waveform, and we have to set the frequency of the function generator at 18 kilohertz and the voltage RMS to be 3.5 volts. We will do this and we'll connect to the oscilloscope and see how the waveform is. I'm setting the function generator to 18 kilohertz AC sine waveform. Power button is here, click on this, and then whatever is blinking is ready for setting. So I have to set 3.5 volts RMS. So I just click on 3.5, punch in the values, and for volt RMS here, VRMS, click on that. So volt RMS is set. 18 kilohertz, how did I set? I clicked on the frequency, and then frequency is blinking. Now whatever value I want to set, I can set 18. And then unit is kilohertz, click on kilohertz, 18 kilohertz signal is set, and offset just leave it like that, it comes up automatically by itself and we are not going to touch it. Next is click the output button so that it lights up, and the signal is going to be available at this output main. I connected the red end of the function generator to the tip of the oscilloscope, and the black end goes to the negative of the oscilloscope, and I put it in 1x position because for 3.5 volts RMS I can expect 5 volts peak and 10 volts peak to peak. I get this waveform on the oscilloscope. As I said before, if it is not showing, click the auto set button. I'm going to read the parameters, the measurements from here. Channel 1, vertical scale is 2.00 volts. The horizontal scale is 25 microseconds. And I'm going to see the peak to peak. Peak to peak is 10.5 volts. I have noted the vertical scale 2.00 volts, horizontal scale 25 microseconds, peak to peak that I read on the oscilloscope 10.5 volts. Period frequency also could be seen from the oscilloscope. You're going to see it now. Click on this and you see the period, it's 55.50 microseconds. I selected frequency through this button and I see 18 kilohertz. Measured frequency and measured RMS value of voltage we are going to see from the function generator setting, not from the DMM. Frequency from here, voltage from here. Note it in the table in these places. See, I have the function as sine wave. I set it at 3.5 volts, 18 kilohertz. When I change the function to square wave, look at the RMS voltage. It has changed to 4.94 volts, close to the peak voltage 5. Now, the square wave is seen on the oscilloscope like this. You see the peak to peak voltage, period. From here, also the frequency. Frequency is 18 kilohertz. Period did not change. 55.5 microseconds. Peak to peak is 10.8 volts. Vertical scale has changed to 5 volts per division. Horizontal scale did not change. 25 microseconds. All of these information could be tabulated here. Vertical scale 5 volts. Horizontal scale 25 microseconds. Peak to peak 10.8. Period 55.60 microsecond, frequency 18 kilohertz, and I added one more row, measured RMS voltage from the DMM, which is from the function generator, 4.95 volts. Sketch the sine waveforms on these two from the oscilloscope and square waveform on this. One more part in this week. You're going to take the pink sheet from the lab kit and you're going to organize the resistors in the same order, fix them up and label them. We are done with this experiment. Thank you for watching.